with the latest updates and insights on world news as it relates to Bible prophecy. Here's Alan Horvath. This is what the LameStream Media is not telling you.
Shalom, my friends. Welcome to this week's newscast. My Red Alert app sounded on Sunday with three alerts, and sirens were sounded throughout the Upper Galilee, including in the cities of Tiberias and Cepheid. However, security officials say the air raid sirens that went off northern Israel on Sunday afternoon were false alarms. There were no signs that rockets had fallen in Israeli territory, and no injuries or damages were reported. Turning to wars and rumors of wars, on Tuesday, July 7th, Syrian troops and pro-government gunmen repelled an offensive by rebels and Muslim militants on a neighborhood in the northern city of Aleppo, while opposition activists claimed that the army carried out a chlorine gas attack in another part of the city. On Wednesday, July 8th, it was reported that on July 5th, ISIS murdered two of Syria's bravest men, 20-year-old Bashir Abdullah Dim al-Sado and 21-year-old Faisal Hussein al-Habib were shown on an ISIS video in orange jumpsuits being forced to confess to spying on the jihadis' activities in northern Syria before being murdered on camera. In recent days, dozens of young men accused of producing or disseminating material showing life under caliphate rule have been arrested by ISIS. And at a rally, also on Wednesday, marking 1 year since last summer's war in Gaza, Hamas displayed a mock-up of a dog tag belonging to slain IDF soldier Oren Shaul, and in an elaborate display, a massive copper fist extending out of a tank held up three identity badges. A Hamas spokesman said, two new locally made missiles represented a qualitative leap forward. Hamas leaders are remaining defiant, insisting that they would continue to pursue the fight against Israel. Then on Thursday, July 9th, a security source in Salahuddin province announced that security forces repelled an ISIS attack southwest of Samarra, killing seven members of the organization. Ynet News reported that two Israelis are believed to be held captive in Gaza. 29-year-old Avera Mengistu from Ashkelon was seen crossing the border fence into Gaza last year of his own volition. The second citizen is a Bedouin who also crossed the border into Gaza of his own accord. Both these young men constitute significant assets for Gaza's Islamist rulers. Israel does not intend to free Palestinian prisoners in exchange for the two Israeli nationals being held in Gaza. Israel sees the cases of Avera Mengistu and the Bedouin Israeli as humanitarian and expects Hamas to release them unharmed, as both sides have done in similar incidents in the past. The Washington Post published an editorial on Tuesday, July 7th, saying that the recent controversy over Iran's compliance with the interim accord, now governing its nuclear work, is troubling. The deal allowed Iran to continue enriching uranium, but required that amounts over a specified ceiling be converted into an oxide powder that cannot easily be further enriched. According to the International Atomic Energy Agency, Iran met the requirement for the total size of its stockpile, but it did so by converting some of its enriched uranium into a different oxide form. And rather than publicly report this departure from the accord, the Obama administration chose to quietly accept it. When the Institute for Science and International Security, a respected independent think tank, pointed out the problem, the Obama administration's response was to rush to Iran's defense and heatedly attack the Institute. The Institute's president, David Albright, and his colleague, Andrea Stricker, stated that this points to a, quote, U.S. willingness to legally reinterpret the deal when Iran cannot do what it said it would do in order to justify that non-performance. Close quote. In other words, overlooking Iranian cheating is easier than confronting it. Iran is believed to have the largest strategic missile force in the Middle East, and its medium-range ballistic missiles could easily deliver a nuclear weapon once Iran builds one. Iran has a likely inventory of more than 800 short- and medium-range ballistic missiles that can reach Israel. And Tehran has built this massive inventory so that it can saturate and thereby overwhelm enemy missile defenses. Its conventional missiles could serve as decoys that enable nuclear missiles to penetrate defenses. Further, an agreement with Iran could give Tehran a $100 billion financial windfall, a sum that even the Obama administration is concerned could be used to finance terrorism against American interests. The threat of a nuclear-capable Iran continues to escalate every week. And that, my friends, is what the LameStream Media is not telling you. Abba willing, I'll see you here again next week. Until then, stay safe. Shalom.
Make sure you hit that like button on YouTube, Facebook, or anywhere else you see it. You can share this video with all your favorite networks by clicking the share button below this video. For weekly insightful newscasts by Alan, make sure you click that YouTube subscribe button.
I don't like crowded rooms. I need more space than I consume. Enough is time alone with you. Underneath a naked moon, sharing confidential moods and making chatter. Mockingbird nocturnal sings, notations of eternal things. Entering the quantum breeze, flying not for want of wings. He lights his gaze on you and me, simply because we matter.